Hello everyone, this is Money Mom. Welcome to the channel. Today I want to talk to you guys about some kitchen saving or time saving hacks that I have in the kitchen. One of them is going to kind of surprise you, so I'm going to get right into it. Now, one of them, you're not saving money, but it saves aggravation. I buy tons of bags of chopped onions because I hate chopping onions. I've tried everything in the book to get me not to tear up, but my eyes burn really bad. And so, you know what? I figured I don't need to do that. I just buy a bunch of bags. I use them sparingly. They're like $1.09 a package, okay? And it takes me a while to go through them. Another thing, I don't buy tons of produce anymore. I've been eating a bag of California Medley every day for the last week, which I love this. All it has is carrots, cauliflower, and broccoli. Absolutely love it. And it's better for me to buy frozen things, fruit and veggies. It saves me time, waste on food, and I can go through it as I see fit. It can stay in the freezer for a long time. Remember, the freezer is your friend. So a lot of the produce I have is frozen. I know you've heard that on other channels before. Okay, this is the big tip that you may be surprised at. I noticed when I was making some pumpkin bread that it was not really cooking really well. I have a newer oven, so I didn't think it was that. And I thought, okay, this pumpkin bread would not totally get done in the middle, but it would be done on the outside. So I thought, what's going on? And I noticed also when I was baking some cookies, some of them just didn't turn out that well. Well, this is what I noticed. I bought a couple, I did some research on some really good air bake bread pans. So I got rid of my older bread pans and bought these newer bread pans, okay? And I think they're in my Amazon store. No obligation. You could do your own research and get your own air bake bread pans yourself if you feel you're in need of them. And so since I bought these pans, I found a set that I love. And you know something? I have not burned any bread and it turns out perfectly. So what I'm basically telling you is if you have something, whether it's cookies, bread, something that doesn't turn out, consider that it might be the utensils or the, you know, pans, the cookie sheets, the bakeware, whatever it is, it may be that may be part of the reason it's not turning out. So I bought these bread pans and the last two loaves of bread turned out great, which brings me to the number two. If I'm gonna make bread, I'm gonna make two. If I'm gonna make lasagna, I'm gonna make two. I make double batches of a lot of stuff and then I freeze them, which saves on a lot of time. I did that with breakfast casserole the other day. I made two of them, so it lasted twice as long. So I do that. Another thing is I don't make meatloaf a lot, and I've had this a while. I buy things that make my life easier. This is a meatloaf pan. This drains all the grease off it, and you just lift this up. I absolutely love it, so that makes my life easier as well. Another thing is that in the morning, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I bulk cook and bake so that we have food all week. I do it in the morning because I used to wait until the afternoon and then I'd be cooking so late and then we'd be eating late at night. So when I get up after my quiet time, the next thing I do is I get in the kitchen and start cooking and baking it and getting it done at the beginning of the day. And I make a whole bunch of it. And one thing I never get rid of are any kind of containers because leftovers can go in here. I make things, I'll put them in the freezer. As a matter of fact, I made my daughter a homemade chocolate bundt cake, which is in here. No, I haven't eaten it all. And I did have one bite to see if it turned out good. But you know what I'm gonna do with this? I'm gonna cut it into several portions, put it in here and freeze it. So that way I'm doing the work once. So that's another little tip. Okay, a couple more little fast tips is that if I really am careful about what I put in the dishwasher, for example, here's an ice cream scoop, right? This ice cream scoop is not to be dishwasher because if it does, this softens ice cream as you scoop it. If we put this in the dishwasher, it will not work. Also, this is a cast iron bundt pan. This is also not supposed to be in the dishwasher. I read on how to care things so I don't make a mistake. A few other quick things is I have a garbage disposal. I don't put anything down there. Now, sometimes flakes of cereal get down there, but I don't put potato peels, grease, anything down there because I want my plumbing to be moving smoothly. Another thing people don't realize is that their dishwasher needs care. at the bottom of your dishwasher, if you have one, you should have a scoop. And I don't need to show it to you right now because I have a bunch of dishes in there, so no worries. But in this dishwasher here at the bottom is something that you can pull out, a trap. And inside there is food, that food gets caught. That needs to be washed out. Otherwise, it can clog your lines. So these are just some tips and tricks that I've noticed. I'm sure I could learn from you guys as well. And another thing that I do, one last thing, and I'm done here, and I might do a part two of this video, is once a week, my daughter and I, the day before we grocery shop, I usually grocery shop once a week, we wipe out and look for expired things, refrigerator, freezer, and organize our pantry. And this way, it keeps us from wasting food. The good news is I'm wasting less and less food, and I'm very aware of things we're not eating, and I'm doing a lot more cooking from scratch on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. I want to hear from you guys in the comments below. Share some of your favorite cooking hacks. I really think my favorite one is be cautious of what you're using to cook or bake things that you have, because you may be using something that doesn't do a good job cooking or baking, and that may be why some of your things are not turning out. I found that out the hard way. I also had to buy a new cake pan because the other one was not cooking the cake evenly. So I want to hear from you guys in the comments below. I always love to hear your tips and tricks. I will talk to you later. I love you. I appreciate you. And I'll see you on tomorrow morning's video, which the title is, I Need to Mind My Own Business. So come back for tomorrow morning's video. Love you. Bye.